Hello and welcome back to a new devlog from me, Bad Graphics. And this week I'm trying to make devlogs a bit differently. Just watch through the video and tell me at the end how you like it better, in this new format or in the old. By the way, if you wonder why I'm changing the channel's name so often, it's because I've recently got a bit of trouble finding a fitting name which is easy to spell and hasn't been taken yet. But I think it will stay at Bad Graphics. Also, if you end up liking this video, consider subscribing. You'll be notified when new devlog comes out and also when this game will be released. It's probably gonna be free, so stay tuned for that. The first thing we're gonna do is improve the player attacks, because for example, when the player is running and attacking at the same time, it doesn't really show any running animations, and that's very bad because it looks horrible. And it would be very much work to create animations for every single scenario, like running and attacking, climbing and attacking, and so on. And that's why I decided to not do that. I'd rather only make movement animations for the player, and for the attacking I'm not gonna play animations but spawn a kind of slash object. So let's first of all make the sprite for the slashing animation. So I've now finished all the sprites, as you can see here, and I'm now gonna do the coding stuff. So as you can see, I made the sprite a bit bigger so that it fits a bit better, and I also made it so that the script plays a sound every time you slash. I hope you can hear that. And it's a pretty bad sound for a sword attack. That's why I'm gonna go now to some websites and search for sword attack sounds. So what I found is this swords pack from Sapsplat. And I think it's really cool. It features some cool sounds like this demo here. And it uses the standard license, which I believe means that you can use it in any commercial projects, but you have to put an attribution to this website into the credits. But I think it's a cool deal. And yes. So I switched out the sounds, and I think that works pretty well. This is how the UI looks right now. I redid the whole mana loading sprite, and what we are now gonna do is make two new enemies for the jungle level part. And this is the slime enemy I had in mind, and an insect enemy. I finished the sprite, and I think it looks quite slime-like. I especially like the kind of reflections here, which make it seem like it's sort of a green jellyfish. And yeah, I think that's enough for today. I'm gonna see you tomorrow. So, it's the second day, and what I'm gonna do is update the background sprites of the game. This is it in Unity. You won't notice any difference because it looks very similar, but for now I'm just gonna take this and move it like this. I know that's a very dirty way of doing it, but it will work for now, because the levels will never get so big that the sky runs out of sky. I thought we'd start off by finishing up our slime enemy, and I also thought, since this isn't a really big project, we shouldn't overshoot our goals. So what I'm gonna do is just archive these 2 points, because I think they are a bit too much. So we're approaching the spot where I placed the first slime enemy. Here it is. And you can see it has a very high jump rate. That makes it kind of funny. Here's another one. Suicide slime, kind of. I remade the hearts entirely, I made some new sprites, and I changed the animations. And it seems to be working now. So, we can change the hearts to being done, and let's make some spikes. I've already made some spikes, sprites, in the last week. I'm gonna use them now and we'll look at it when I'm finished. And just like this, we've got some spikes. And if you step in them too long, they kill you. So today is the last day and we're gonna look at lava sparks. Kind of like the sparks in Super Mario, which shoot out of the lava in regular intervals and apply damage when they touch you. So these are new lava sparks. I'm pretty happy how they turned out. And what I can do now is adjust some settings like how fast they pop or the offset at which they spawn, which is pretty useful for level design like this. But tell me what you think about it. If you have any improvements in mind, just comment them. We're getting very close to the ending. So the lava sparks are done. Let's move them over here. So the things we're gonna do next week is make some new game mechanics like falling objects and lava shooting pipes and turrets. That's a topic I'm really looking forward to, because that will probably look very nice. And when we're done with these two, and these two things up as well, then we can focus on finishing the game. That includes the boss fights, polishing and bug fixing and so on. Then making some cutscenes, which I'm also looking forward to. Making a trailer, which will be pretty similar to making cutscenes, I suppose. And then releasing the game. So I hope you enjoyed this devlog. It's a new type of devlog, for me at least. Be sure to also check out other videos. I've got a link up here if you don't forget it. And thanks so much for watching.